Welcome to The Truth About Lending. I'm Melinda Payne, the president and owner of The Truth About Lending. I've been a licensed mortgage broker for over 25 years and bring you clear and straightforward insights on everything from securing your initial home purchase to refinancing your house or obtaining condo financing in Florida's dynamic lending market. Now let's get into The Truth About Lending. No, you're not alone. I'm gonna make this place your home. Hi, everyone. Welcome to Mortgages with Melinda. This week, we're going to talk about getting mortgage ready. Guys, what can you do to improve your odds of getting the best possible rate and having the easiest process or easier process through underwriting and qualifying for the most home that you would like to buy? Well, there's a lot of really important things to keep in mind when buying a house. The first most important thing is you really want to have your credit in the best possible light. That means if you can pay down any credit card debt, at least probably about a good 45 days before you apply for a mortgage, that would be the best possible option. Now, if you can't do that, one of our loan officers who's evaluating your situation will go over with you your credit. And if there's any improvements that we see that you could do in a very short time period, because we do have the ability to do a rapid rescore with your credit. However, there is a cost that's associated with that. So it's better to try to make sure you've got all of your credit cards, specifically your revolving debt. This does not apply to car loans. This does not apply to student loans or boat payments or something that's an installment loan. We're really kind of looking at your revolving debt. Okay. We want to make sure that you have a limit that, your balance is about 30% of your available credit limit. So the dollar amount is not what's important. It's the percentage that's what's important. For example, if you have a $200 credit limit and you have a $195 balance on it, then you're really maxed out. And then you're in a position where you really don't have as good of a credit rating as if you had that balance on the credit card at $60 or 30% of the available credit limit. So it's really important that you understand that it's not the dollar amount. Having a $200 credit limit with a $190 balance is same effect as if you had a $2,000 or $20,000 credit limit that was maxed out as well. Okay. It's the percentage of your available credit limit. So there's two different tiers. One is 30% and the other one is 50%. If you can get your credit limit at 50%, if you can get your credit balance at 50% or less of your available credit limit, then it would be better than if it was maxed out. Or if you can get it at 30% of your available credit limit, that's really going to give you the best bang for your buck. Also, If you know you're going to be applying for a mortgage, don't make minimum credit card payments. You will have your credit rating based on your payment history on your credit cards. Pay an extra $20, pay an extra $50, something that's over the amount of what you owe so that you can put yourself in a position where your credit score is the best possible light. Okay. Now, another tip on getting mortgage ready is to make sure that you're reviewing how much money that you need for closing with the loan officer and discussing the strategies of where you're getting that money from. It's super important that you're planning ahead any large transactions that need to be moved and documenting them in that way. So have a discussion with the loan officer a good few months before you're going to apply for a mortgage so that if you're getting a gift or you're moving money or whatever the case may be, that you have a game plan of exactly how you need to do that, okay? Also, another really important thing, if you're in the process of going through a divorce, you must be legally divorced before you apply for a mortgage, or your spouse, even if you're not divorced, still has to sign some documents. So getting mortgage ready could involve you resolving your marital status, or if you're in the process of getting married and making sure that you guys are both listed as married, as a married couple together on the application. Now, one other thing important about getting mortgage ready is if you're self-employed and you plan on doing a regular normal income documentation loan, is having your tax returns prepared. Now, you don't necessarily need to have the most current year prepared if you are on an extension and the extension period has not passed. So if you have taken an extension on your taxes and you still have till October to submit them or September to submit them, whatever the case may be, then we can use the prior year's taxes. But if the extension period has passed, let's say it's November and we're already past the October extension, then we need to have the tax returns completed. It's a good idea to have your loan officer review your taxes prior to you filing so that the person can, so that your loan officer can give you an opinion on how that affects your ability to qualify and ask questions regarding things that your CPA may or may not be able to do in reference to categorizing certain deductions. Another thing that's super important regarding getting mortgage ready is making sure that you're documenting any payments that are paid by others. So let's say you've co-signed for your brother's car and he's paying it. You want to make sure you gather the last 12 months of car payments that he's paid to prove that he's paying out of his bank account so that we don't count that payment in your debt to income ratio. Also, another good tip regarding getting mortgage ready is when you're paying your rent, make sure you're keeping proof of the rental payments that you're paying in case we need to document the last 12 months of your rental history and we can prove that you've been paying it on time. Guys, this has been just a quick overview of some mortgage tips to get mortgage ready. For a more in-depth discussion of exactly what you need to do for your individual situation, please reach out to one of our loan officers where we can really make a great plan that's unique to you. Also, please make sure you like this video on our YouTube channel and subscribe so that you can get our weekly mortgage tips. And if you have any questions or like to speak to one of our loan officers, please reach us at 888-76-TRUTH, or you can visit us online at thetruthaboutlending.com. Have a great day, everybody, and see you next week on Mortgages with Melinda.
Thank you for listening to The Truth About Lending. Stay up to date with all Florida loan and mortgage news by subscribing to our channel and help us grow so we can continue bringing you insight and advice. Please like, share, and follow us on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, and LinkedIn. You can find the links to all our social media profiles in the description. You can find extra resources on our website, thetruthaboutlending.com. If you have any questions about Florida mortgages, we are licensed and ready to talk to you today. Call us at 888-76-TRUTH. That's 888-768-7884. You can also email us at melinda@ttal.info or visit us at our website, thetruthaboutlending.com. Until next time, remember, the truth about lending is out there for you.
No, you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home.